Welcome to another edition of OCD Hi-Fi Guy. What do we have in store for you today? Look at this beast we're looking at. That is the new Dutch & Dutch 8C active monitor. This puppy is something else. We got in the front a 6.5 and a tweeter. And on the back, let's see if I can get back here because there's very slim space. I don't know if you can see in. Here, let me try and rotate this without dropping it. You see that? Dual 8-inch woofers. Say, what? Yeah, dual 8s back there. So let me rotate this without dropping my camera. Okay, yeah, so we got dual 8s in the back, 6.5, and a tweet up front in an active monitor package. So there's amps in the back here. Well, they got several amps inside each one, but this is our inlet. And you can see there's a power, so all you do is put a power, and you've got the direct in the AES, the XLR, you know, digital, so AES EBU input that is coming from, it's being fed from this Metrum audio streamer. So this is a Roon bridge. So we come out of the back of this puppy, AES, we go over here, and we pop into one of the speakers, and then we come back out of the speaker with another AES. And we take that and we go over to the speaker on this side. Okay, we also take some Ethernet cables. There's two Ethernet cables. And the Ethernet cables go straight down to a router. I put a wireless router just under here because there's no Ethernet out here in this area. So you just plug in a repeater and you can plug right into there. You know, it's basically an endpoint. You get your internet directly to each speaker, actually. So it goes out of the router that's underneath there. We go out of the router, two Ethernet cables, one to each speaker. And then we've got the AES comes out of the Metrum, goes up to this certain speaker, and then pops out and goes to this one. So, and then you plug them each into the wall, okay? Now, for that, you get, really, we could move this, but you have no rig to concern yourself with. So that is really something that I find that is especially attractive about these speakers is they work without a rig. So you can put them in wherever you want to put them. Well, I mean, seriously, these things are 4 inches from the wall. Okay, try and do that with a hi-fi speaker. I don't think so. It's not going to work. Sound like crap. So these have a very special algorithm built in. And it's part of the interface that you use on your tablet or your phone. And you tell it, okay, you punch in the information, how far this is. This is 10 centimeters from that wall. So you tell it, and what it does is it compensates, and I'm not sure if it's delay or what how it compensates out the back, but it does that so that the wave coming around matches with this, and it gets a full cardioid pattern and perfect dispersion. So that's really something else. You can really tell when you put these on. Now, another thing to note about these is they play incredibly loud and with tons of bass. So look, this is, if you're having guests over and you're going to have a party, man, I mean, these things are the bomb. There's no question about it. These things are louder than many floor standards I've heard. Not that, you know, loudness is everything, but I'm just telling you, when you want to put the pedal to the metal, you really can. And I'll do an example of that in a second here. For now, I'm just going to tell you about these speakers. So they have other stands. These are ones I grabbed off Sonos Fobbers that I have, and just kind of made these up real quick. But that is the Dutch & Dutch 8C is the name of the speaker, and they're just incredible. Again, it's something different, I would say, than hi-fi. You know, hi-fi is what I do in the other room, and these are something that hi-fi cannot do, which is be put up against a wall and not need a rig. Like these things, you can just tuck them up against a wall and pretty much in anything. I have them right here, so it can show you. It's right in the middle of the living room with chairs and stuff, and you just put those things in, put them right against the wall, you're good. Now, I know a lot of you need to put your speakers against the wall for the WAF or whatever it is. You need to have speakers against the wall. You don't get the luxury that I do of putting magna pans in the middle of the room like I do over in that other room and just having, you know, the full-on cave where I get to do whatever I want. Well, this is more realistically how people have audio systems. It's in shared space where they need to share it with their, you know, significant others with little kidlets running around or whatever. But these are out of the way. The back is up against the wall, so kids can't get at the knobs and tweak with anything or whatever, man. They're pretty kid-proof, I'd say, and very robust, as long as it doesn't fall on them. Well, you should see the stands. They're doing sound anchor stands. Okay, and the sound anchor stands have four legs. So one, you know, four, it's much more sturdy. This is even sturdy, but this is topply compared to what Dutch and Dutch has as an option for these 8Cs. So anyways, let's get on with the music part. I'm just going to play a little bit of music, and then I'll commence our time checking out the Dutch and Dutch 8C. It's highly recommended. I've heard the key. I've heard the other active monitors that are out right now and popular, and there's nothing that has the slam and the wow factor that these do. They're simply, I mean, well, you'll hear in a second. Okay, I used to do car audio. That was a lot of fun. This is even more fun. Okay, so I'm gonna come back in a second, and we will do the audio portion of this. But again, it's the Dutch and Dutch 8C. They're made in the Netherlands, home of many great audio products, which is the Metrum is too, also from Netherlands. So that's that. We're going to play some music now. And again, Dutch and Dutch 8C active monitor. Excellent. Recommended product is for exactly what you see here. Just tuck and forget, set and forget, really. And then you control it using your tablet or your iPhone or whatever, and you're good to go. All right, I'll be back. Okay, so here we are back for the audio portion of the test. This shows you the interface of the 8C. You go back to our settings. You know, that's got a night mode that will kind of chill the bass out if you got neighbors. And the front LED, you can turn the LED on or off. See in this, I go back. Okay, this is the volume, that's the night mode icon. So there's the two speakers. This is the grouping, the two of them together, and this is each one individually and the parameters. If we go in here, you can see this is one of the speakers. We go into its individual settings. We've got the model, the version, the group that it's in, the placement, whether it's left, right, center, front LED, it's got a low latency option. Treble, bass, and sub for an EQ with the front wall and side wall to tell you, you know, how far from the front and the side. So it's pretty cool, man. This thing's really adjustable, and more features are coming. They're working on them now. Okay, so let's see. I don't know if you can tell. This is totally loud. It's pretty kick-ass, man. That's one thing. These are for sure. Here it comes. Back and turn it up. It's already pretty low. Listen to that bass. You would not believe the bass in here. It's so tight. Perfect. I don't know if you can hear that. Okay. We're compressing the air in here. It's fucking crazy. Yep, let's get ready to drop. Here comes the drop. comes the drop. Okay, so I don't dare turn them up anymore because I'm afraid. Look at that. Mirror is precariously set on that granite and that block of wood, and that thing is heavy. And I'll bet we'd knock it off, and it would topple down and be a big crash, and then I would feel stupid, and you guys would laugh. So we know that volume isn't everything, right? But I wanted to do that on purpose. I wanted to do that on purpose because that is something that these speakers do that no other will, okay? You won't put an audio rig up in here that is hi-fi and do anywhere near that volume without any sort of distortion or clipping or, you know, smoke. I mean, that's unbelievable. These are monitors, man. Okay, so these things are nuts. They're full bore, full tilt. So for those of you that are full tilt people, these are your full tilt monitors. Get them because they're so worth it. All right, so that's it. Any questions? Look up Dutch and Dutch, man. They're the ones. Cheers and have a good one. Okay, audiophiles, you know I didn't leave you out. I'm gonna Wagner all over you. Here she comes. Wait till this gets big. Okay, so, nice. Uh-oh, I feel it coming. Duck and cover. Okay, so we're gonna turn this up a tad bit. We'll see, because this is also, large orchestral stuff is hard to do. Let's see. We can also adjust EQ if we want, you know, depending on the room dynamics or the room frequency response. If I can find some of the heavy stuff here. Go to Roon. Let me check it out. See if I can get over here. Okay. Dude, that's no joke. This is like heavy metal from back then. Like, this guy was kicking ass, totally. Okay, so there you go. That's hard. That's also hard to do. Dynamics like that, with that kind of, timpani, that's intense. All right, everybody. See you soon.